Attack. This is the apex predator of the undersea world. An attack submarine is a vessel designed for one primary mission: to hunt and destroy enemy submarines and surface warships. Attack submarines can be nuclear-powered or diesel-electric, including AIP, and nuclear-powered boats can stay submerged for months, limited mainly by food and maintenance. They are the ultimate stealth platform, covered in sound-dampening tiles and equipped with incredibly sensitive sonar arrays to detect and track targets from immense distances. They are armed with heavyweight torpedoes and anti-ship missiles. Famous examples include the American Virginia class and the Russian Akula class. SSBN. An SSBN is a warship built around strategic nuclear deterrence, carrying submarine-launched ballistic missiles. An SSBN, often called a boomer, has one sole, terrifying purpose: to provide a nation's ultimate nuclear deterrent. These are massive submarines, designed to carry multiple submarine-launched ballistic missiles, each armed with multiple nuclear warheads. Their mission is to disappear into the depths of the ocean and remain completely undetected for their entire patrol. They are the most survivable leg of the nuclear triad, ensuring that even if a country is destroyed in a first strike, its SSBNs can unleash a devastating retaliatory blow. The American Ohio class is the classic example. SSGN. This is a modern evolution of the attack submarine, designed for overwhelming conventional firepower. An SSGN is a guided missile submarine designed or modified to carry large numbers of cruise missiles and often support special operations, and some are converted SSBNs. For example, the U.S. Navy's four Ohio-class SSGNs converted 22 of their 24 Trident tubes to carry up to 154 Tomahawk missiles total, while the remaining two tubes were converted for special operations lockout chambers. This gives a single, stealthy submarine the ability to deliver a devastating barrage of precision strikes against land targets from a hidden, submerged position. SSK. This is the most common type of non-nuclear submarine, often called a conventional submarine. An SSK is powered by diesel engines on the surface, or while snorkeling, which charge massive batteries that then allow it to run silently underwater. While they lack the unlimited range and endurance of a nuclear submarine, modern SSKs are incredibly stealthy. When running on their batteries, they are almost silent, making them extremely effective hunters in coastal and shallow water environments. Many modern designs now incorporate air-independent propulsion systems, allowing them to stay submerged for weeks instead of days. Minelayer. While most modern submarines can deploy mines from their torpedo tubes, a dedicated minelayer submarine is a vessel specifically designed or converted to carry and lay a large number of naval mines. This is a stealthy and effective form of area denial. A mine-laying submarine can covertly enter an enemy's strategic waterways or harbor entrances and deploy a minefield without being detected, creating a deadly, hidden threat to enemy shipping that can remain in place for a long time. Midget. A midget submarine is any submarine under 150 tons, operated by a very small crew of one to a handful of sailors. They are often used for special operations, harbor penetration, and other short-range covert missions. They are designed to covertly transport combat divers or naval commandos from a larger mothership submarine to a hostile shore for reconnaissance or sabotage missions. They are also used for harbor penetration and intelligence gathering in areas that are too shallow or restricted for a full-size submarine to operate. Transport/cargo. This is a specialized submarine designed primarily to transport cargo or personnel. While many special mission subs can carry small teams, a true transport submarine is built to move larger numbers of troops or critical supplies under the water. This concept has been used for covertly supplying resistance forces or for logistical support in areas where surface transport is too vulnerable. Modern concepts often focus on using large unmanned submarines for this logistical role. Special mission/intelligence. This is a highly specialized and often secretive type of submarine modified for intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance missions. These submarines are outfitted with unique sensor arrays, advanced signals intelligence equipment, and specialized gear for undersea operations. Their missions can include tapping undersea communication cables, deploying and recovering intelligence packages from the seabed, and conducting covert surveillance of enemy naval bases. The U.S. Navy's USS Jimmy Carter, modified with a multi-mission platform for specialized missions, is a well-known example of this type. UUV. This is the future of undersea warfare. A UUV, or underwater drone, is a robotic, autonomous submarine that can perform a wide range of missions without a human crew on board. They come in all sizes. Small UUVs can be launched from a submarine's torpedo tube to conduct mine hunting or intelligence gathering. Large, long-endurance UUVs are being developed to patrol vast areas of the ocean for months at a time, tracking enemy submarines. And some, like Russia's Poseidon, are designed as massive nuclear-powered torpedoes. DSRV. This is the ambulance of the submarine world. A DSRV is a type of midget submarine designed for one mission: to rescue the crew of a disabled submarine that is trapped on the ocean floor. A DSRV is air transportable and can be deployed to the site of a disaster anywhere in the world. It can dive down, mate to a disabled submarine's rescue hatch, and ferry survivors to a rescue ship or mother submarine in small groups. AGSS. This is a category for non-combatant submarines used for scientific research, testing, and development. These vessels, often designated as AGSS, are used to test new sonar systems, hull designs, and quieting technologies that will be used on future combat submarines. They also serve as platforms for deep ocean research and oceanographic mapping. The U.S. Navy's NR-1, a unique nuclear-powered deep submergence research submarine, is a famous historical example. Radar Picket. This was a specialized type of submarine that became prominent in the early Cold War, before the age of satellites and advanced airborne radar. A radar picket submarine was a conventional submarine that was modified with a large air search radar. Its mission was to station itself off an enemy's coast and provide early warning of a surprise bomber attack. As airborne and satellite radar technology improved, this specialized role became obsolete, and the submarines were retired or converted. Thanks for watching. Which submarine type do you think will matter most in the next major naval conflict, and why? Let me know what you think in the comments. Please remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video.